Good evening, everyone. Welcome into our special coverage here on the Weather Channel. We are tracking Tropical Storm Bonnie along the southeast coast. I'm Mike Bettis.
And I'm Nick Walker. We also want to welcome our friends watching us live on Local Now. Let's take you into North Carolina right now, and we're continuing to find more of that rain invading some of the coastal regions. Not a lot of wind as of yet, though.
No. Well, let's get you an update on what exactly is happening right there at the water's edge. Meteorologist Mike Seidel, he is in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina this evening. Mike, so many folks, I'm sure, want to be out there and they want to be enjoying the water for this holiday weekend. Update us what conditions are like.
Hang on, guys.
Hey guys, rain coming into Myrtle Beach, and it's putting a damper on the weekend activities here for the holiday. But until noon today, it was dry, and this is just another light, pesky shower. I noticed on a radar that as they roll in here in the past hour or so, they've been weakening. So again, we're not getting the kind of rain we've seen down in the Lowcountry, Charleston area, some of those areas like Berkeley, Dorchester counties, and we've had upwards of local reports of 3 inches of rain. We could see another 1 to 3 inches. The National Weather Service not overly concerned because it's been fairly dry going into this, and the rainfall gets spread out over several days. This is the hardest we've had rainfall day enough to put the old hood up on the L.L. Bean jacket. As far as today, though, the surf was up around 2 to 3 footers, but it's those rip currents, and that's why they kept the bathers knee-deep for a while, and then they said, hey, that's it, ankle deep, no going in the water. The lifeguards are, you know, they're the professionals. The red flags will be flying again tomorrow, no doubt. Again, it's a function of the weather, even though today when we have some light rain or still folks in the water. Water temperature now up around 75 degrees, so it's getting in that range where, I'd say I could. Most of us could deal with that if it's nice and toasty on the beach, say up in the mid to the upper 80s. Give it another 3 or 4 weeks on the Grand Strand, and that water temperature will be back above 80 for the rest of the summer. That sounds more like it. As far as the impacts, again, it's just the rainfall, the rip currents. There's little, if any, wind out here tonight. There's the trees, the Palmetto State, South Carolina, and you can notice not a whole lot of movement. And we've had maybe gusts of 15 this afternoon. And actually yesterday, with the sun out, we had a little bit more wind. We had some churning and turning over of the atmosphere. So your holiday forecast, much what we see here, on and off showers, maybe some heavier downpours. Don't think we're going to have any wind gusts more than 25 or 30 miles an hour. So we're not going to have any impacts with trees and limbs and power lines. It's just more of kind of an inconvenience, especially when you come down here and you pluck down a lot of money and you want some great beach weather. A couple guys over here, where are you from?
Fort Mill, South Carolina.
Where?
Fort Mill, South Carolina.
Fort Mill, South Carolina. I know where that is. And how long are you down here for?
Till Monday.
Monday. What about the weather?
We thought it was going to be nicer.
Did you watch the Weather Channel?
We did, but we thought we could sneak in a couple of days at the beach today. Well, a couple of minutes.
Well, if you've gotten out early, but you weren't up early enough.
Yes, sir, yeah.
Well, enjoy the weather nonetheless. Did you just finish high school, graduate?
No, sir. We're going to be seniors.
Seniors. Well, good luck in your senior year.
Thank you. You got a
shout out for the high school?
Fort Mill Yellow Jackets.
Fort Mill Yellow Jackets. Nice. Nice to see you. Enjoy the rest of your weekend despite the rain. Fort Mill Yellow Jackets. Mike Bettis, Nick Walker, there you go.
All right.
They're making the best of it.
Right? A little sting in the forecast, yeah. I'm sure, for those Yellow Jackets. But all things considered, you can make something out of it. This is not going to be one of those where you've got to evacuate or anything like
that. Exactly. You can still stay in place.
Sure.
Just come up with some sort of plan B. But what do we have yet to deal with there around the South Carolina coast, Michael?
Well, the rip currents and the rainfall, as Mike was saying. When you look at the wind reports right now, Hilton Head north at 18, gusting to 26. Charleston Executive north at 15, gusting to 21. And in Beaufort, it's gusting to 23. So, we're not seeing 40-mile-per-hour winds. And when you look at the maximum winds, and I'll show you the current stats in a minute, of 40 miles per hour, that's the maximum wind anywhere within the system. So the bulk of the rainfall is still yet to come, actually, believe it or not, offshore. I want to show you this graphic. This is the flight tracker of the Hurricane Hunters. The system is right in here, and the plane, the Air Force Hurricane Hunter airplane, has been out Sampling this storm, looking at what's happening underneath those cloud tops now all evening long, and they're the ones that are able to tell us how strong this is, and they're still finding those winds of about 35 to 40 miles per hour at any location. At, you know, it could be one location within the storm, and the pressure is down to about 1,007 millibars. What's most interesting, though, of the recent developments is this. It's not moving. It's stationary right now, and you can see that the cloud tops are all to the north of this. So if it sits in place, there's enough convergence, winds coming together within this low pressure system to continue to fire off the convection and the thunderstorms. So this is going to be, unfortunately, not a storm that's just going to just run into the coast like a lot of them do. It's going to meander and then sort of edge its way toward the coastline. Here's the satellite picture, and really the bulk of the rain has been down here in the low country. Charleston, Folly Beach down to Hilton Head have bore the brunt of the, at least of the rainfall. Here's where the center of this is. Myrtle Beach, where Mike Seidel is, not too bad. You can see some of these heavier showers that are moving into Wilmington, but not the conventional structure of a tropical cyclone. We're not seeing those spiral rain bands that are just feeding over the same area. It's more of a big shield of rain. And then Mike and Nick, as you look at the forecast for this, it's going to take its sweet time. That means a lot of rainfall into Monday and Tuesday, even up and through the mid-Atlantic. Back to you.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. Let's update you now on what's going on with the severe side of everything this evening. It includes St. Louis, Missouri, with a squall line. It's not too far off from you. It's 83 degrees right now, so it's been a warm day for us here, the gateway to the west. I'm going to update you on some of the storms we've got out there right now. It does include the Midwest, does include portions of the southern plains. So if you live in, say, Milwaukee or Chicago, wouldn't be surprised to see a few storms that come calling for you. All right, on the radar, you'll end up seeing that we have some storms out there scattered in nature across the center of the country. There's that squall line now across the Midwest in St. Louis. It may end up being just to your south. Now, let's head a little farther north here through the Chicagoland area, DeKalb County right now, under a severe thunderstorm warning. So heads up on wind and hail with this. 8:45, the expiration on that. Look at this significant line that's coming now through Wisconsin. Sheboygan, Milwaukee, and Waukegan will all get nailed by this. No warnings with it right now, but there is a decent amount of hail that will fall from this. So watch for some hail to come your way. Likely going to be less than an inch in diameter, but at some of its peak here near Summit, hail size is about an inch and a half. Here's a look at the forecast as we go through the remainder of the evening. We'll lose some instability once the sun goes down, and the storms will begin to die down somewhat here. I think Chicago, you'll be in much better shape. Milwaukee as well when you head out tomorrow morning for maybe some donuts and coffee. I think you'll be all right. Around Phelps County here, down in Rolla on I-44 in Missouri, severe thunderstorm warning for us. This goes until 8:45 this evening. Then look at the storms that have exploded here in Texas this evening, including a severe thunderstorm warning in Abilene. This includes Taylor County. Severe thunderstorm warning till 9 o'clock this evening. We'll watch for some larger hail embedded within that storm. Places like Abilene, Impact, and Ty, heads up on the storm coming your way. Nick?
All right, let's take it a little farther north now where, boy, it was warm today in Boston, and it still is. 84 degrees as we head into your evening hours right now after a 92-degree high. That actually tied the record for the date. Tell you what, it has been so incredibly warm. We'll continue to see more warmth here around the Northeast as we head through your holiday weekend. Maybe not quite hitting 92, though, in Boston, I don't think. We did hit a record high in Albany, New York. As a matter of fact, broke over 100-year-old record there by a couple of degrees. Boston, there's your record from 1931 that you tied. And Concord, New Hampshire, you tied your record from 1978. Newark, New Jersey, beat your record from 1959 by 4 degrees. More warmth ahead, though, as we head into tomorrow's, because what we've got, this area of high pressure that's helping to steer Bonnie toward the Carolinas, is also bringing lots of warmth with those southerly winds. So we'll see those temperatures 10 to 20 degrees above the average as we head into tomorrow. A lot of 80s and near 90s once again. Stay with us for more.
Currently in our area, 79 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment. I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It transformed treatment as the first cure that's one pill once a day for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. Harvoni is a simple treatment regimen that's been prescribed to more than 250,000 patients. Tell your doctor if you've had a liver transplant, other liver or kidney problems, HIV, or any other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Taking amiodarone with Harvoni may cause a serious slowing of your heart rate. Common side effects of Harvoni may include tiredness, headache, and weakness. I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
Don't let dust and allergies get between you and life's beautiful moments. With Flonase Allergy Relief, they won't. Most allergy pills only control one inflammatory substance. Flonase controls six, and six is greater than one. Flonase changes everything.
With an unlimited mileage warranty on your certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz, you can drive as far as you want for up to 3 years and be covered. So no matter where you go, your peace of mind and confidence will be as unlimited as your mileage. Visit the certified pre-owned sales event now through May 31st and learn more about our unlimited mileage warranty only at your authorized dealer. Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing.
I've had a wonderful time tonight.
Me too.
Call me tomorrow?
I'm going to send a vague text in a couple days that leaves you confused about my level of interest.
I'll wait a full 2 days before responding.
Perfect. We're never going to see each other again, will we?
No.
Wouldn't it be great if everyone said what they meant? The Citi Double Cash Card does. It lets you earn double cash back. 1% when you buy and 1% as you pay. The Citi Double Cash Card. Double means double.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you. We're never having kids.
Breathe. I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We are never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, State Farm is there.
If you have moderate to severe plaque psoriasis, isn't it time to let the real you shine through? Introducing Otezla, apremilast. Otezla is not an injection or a cream. It's a pill that treats plaque psoriasis differently. Some people who took Otezla saw 75% clearer skin after 4 months. And Otezla's prescribing information has no requirement for routine lab monitoring. Don't take Otezla if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. Otezla may increase the risk of depression. Tell your doctor if you have a history of depression or suicidal thoughts or if these feelings develop. Some people taking Otezla reported weight loss. Your doctor should monitor your weight and may stop treatment. Side effects may include diarrhea, nausea, upper respiratory tract infection, and headache. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you're pregnant or planning to be. Ask your dermatologist about Otezla today. Otezla. Show more of you.
All right, so some folks out there enjoying their time at the beach. However, things are going downhill now that we've got Tropical Storm Bonnie that's very near the shoreline. Michael Lowry joining us now here in the lab once again. Explain the danger that people don't often think about.
No.
Rip currents.
No. Rip currents are those, we call them the rivers of the ocean because if you get stuck in one, Mike, it can pull you out to sea. Mm-hmm. And I get into this argument a lot with folks. Rip currents do not pull you under. There's nothing in the ocean aside from a shark or maybe a wave that sort of throws you down that's going to pull you under
it
the water.
It takes you out.
It takes
not
you out.
Down.
Right. So that's key because if you know that, if you're being taken out, you're not going to be taken under. You want to try to stay afloat if you're caught in one. Don't panic because people drown from panicking with rip currents.
Okay. So let's talk about how it all comes together and how we know to spot a rip current.
Well, the way rip currents are formed, you have breaking waves that are breaking over a sandbar, and what they do is they carve a channel within the sandbar, and on either side of that channel, you have higher water levels, so you have high pressure on either side, and you have low pressure in between, and kind of like air moving from high to low pressure, the water moves from high to low pressure, and so you have a return current that goes out to sea. And these currents can be 4 or 5 miles per hour, which doesn't sound like a lot for people on land, but in the water, that's as fast as a Michael Phelps is going to swim. So you can't really swim against these things. I mean, your best bet is if you're caught in one is to look for the waves on either side of the rip currents because the rip current itself generally don't have waves in them. The waves will push you back to sea,
okay.
And you can see the waves on either side of the rip currents. And I want to get to this video before we go because the video really shows you, Mike, what a rip current is.
This
and how
is
it
really
works.
Fascinating. Dye was placed in the water to pick out the movement of the water.
Right, so you can see this, the water's moving this way, and then on either side of the rip current, you have the wave action, but in the middle, snuggled in the middle, where you have a break in the waves, is where the rip current is. But notice, Mike, the green dye sort of curling back. So if you stay in the rip current long enough, a lot of these rip currents, 50, 60, 70% in some cases of the rip currents, will actually just take you right back to the beach. So, one of your best bets is just to stay afloat and to ride it out.
Let it take you out, and if you find yourself out too deep, you can always signal for a lifeguard and they can come out and
That's
get
right.
you if you don't have the strength to come
That's
back
right.
in, but just stay on top of the water.
Yes.
All right,
yeah.
Michael, thank you very much. All right, Nick.
All right, thanks so much, guys. Fascinating stuff. Hey, Mike Seidel is in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. He's live now with the latest. And Mike, those flags went up on the beaches warning folks to stay out of the water as we head through the rest of the weekend.
Yeah, the red flags are up today. They had no rescues, no saves, and that's because they kept the folks basically knee-deep and then ankle-deep, and that's the way to go. And if you have to swim, even if there aren't any rip currents forecast, stay near a lifeguard stand. Don't get yourself in trouble. Down here, we've had really no trouble. This is the heaviest rainfall, shower, downpour we've had the entire day. And we've been, nickel and dimed, less than a tenth of an inch, but we'll easily double that with this particular shower. Palmetto trees not moving much. That's the spring-made pier out there. Very famous pier. It's been here for years and years and years. And we've got the palm trees around the pool at the hotel. Notice there is not much wind. It's not a wind story with this. This is a very minimal tropical storm. And again, unless you get a squall, even down in Charleston, the airport, again, is inland. It's only had winds running at about 15 miles an hour at peak. But down there, they've had upwards locally of 3 inches of rain. So this is going to be the story tonight and tomorrow, on and off showers. And that's it, Nick, and the elevated rip current risk. So much more of a kind of a nuisance on a holiday weekend than where you have to board up, evacuate, worry about power outages or anything like that.
All right. Thanks so much, Mike. Hey, stay with us. We've got severe weather to talk about as well as the tropics just ahead.
Well, well, look at that. Someone is carrying locally grown produce, picked at peak of season freshness. Guess who it could be? Better yet, try it at Walmart's low prices.
Flea bites can mean misery for your cat. Advantage 2 Monthly Topical kills fleas through contact. Fleas do not have to bite your cat to die. Advantage 2, fight the misery of biting fleas.
A generation has grown up trusting the Weather Channel. Coming to us for the most accurate forecast.
This is all heading into your area right now.
Relying on us for the most trusted storm coverage.
We are in the height of the storm.
There is still a lot of flooding.
There's a tornado.
Whoa! And now, choosing us as the highest-ranked TV news brand for 6 years in a row. Where you get your weather matters. So thank you for trusting the leading experts in weather.
Currently in our area, 79 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7 day outlook.
ASE certified technicians of Firestone Complete Auto Care prove a tool's only as good as the hands behind it. Right now, purchase a set of four eligible Firestone tires and get a $60 Firestone Visa prepaid card by mail. Whatever you drive, drive a Firestone.
Firestone Complete Auto Care, celebrating 90 years of keeping cars running newer longer.
The Ram 1500 delivers an uncompromising combination of power and efficiency. So what does that mean? It means a Ram 1500 just ended the debate between power and efficiency. The Ram 1500 is the most fuel-efficient full-size pickup ever.
Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to $2,000 bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
More people are driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts, glory, Ram.
I see the light shining on me. I'm coming home for the summer.
I see the every backyard comes together around a grill and Kingsford charcoal. Gather round and try our smoky and savory charcoal with hickory.
When you're a fan, it's never just one thing, it's everything. Introducing NASCAR on Xfinity X1. Get live race stats right on your TV. Change the way you experience NASCAR with Xfinity X1.
On the train test range, you learn what makes our heating and cooling systems so reliable. If there's a breaking point, we'll find it. It's hard to stop a train. Really hard. Train, the most reliable for a reason.
What makes me a weather geek? The fact that I love the weather, especially when it's hit me in the side of the face.
I'm gonna ride this one out, guys.
Be one of the thousands of weather geeks out there at weloveweather.tv.
50 past the hour. Welcome back into our continuing coverage of Tropical Storm Bonnie tonight.
And we are taking time out now for our tropical update. Let's turn to hurricane specialist Michael Lowry. And Michael, we're not talking about an historic storm here.
No.
But the timing is bad, and a lot of folks are going to remember it probably for that reason.
Yeah, and I think too, Nick, we're 4 days away from the official, the traditional start of the hurricane season. The hurricane season starts when the first storm forms of the year. The first storm formed back in January. That was Hurricane Alex in the far eastern Atlantic. And now we're dealing with the second named storm. And again, not even to the traditional start of the hurricane season. on June the 1st. Let's get to the latest information on Tropical Storm Bonnie here. This is as of 8 o'clock Eastern time from the National Hurricane Center. And we'll get an update from them coming up at 11 o'clock Eastern time. And with that update, we'll see whether or not, what they do with this. But I think that will continue to be a 40-mile-per-hour tropical storm, 130 miles to the east, or southeast, I should say, Beaufort, South Carolina. And here's really the news of the night is that it's stationary. It's not moving. And that's not good when you have a storm that sort of stalls out just off the coastline because there are still warm waters here. And you notice to the north, most of the weather is up here to the north of where the center is. And with that being the case, the convergence and the winds coming together will continue to produce the showers and thunderstorms so long as this is over warm waters. So want to keep an eye on this one. But at the end of the day, this is going to be sort of just a rain out if you're headed to the beach or if you're already at the beach or living at the beach. Let's talk about the hurricane hunters for a minute. We send these planes out into tropical storms, into hurricanes, into storms that even haven't formed. And what their job is to do is to look at what the storm, to look underneath the clouds at what is happening inside of the storm. And they're able to tell us how strong it is. And that's why we feel comfortable with the information that we have in terms of its strength. The hurricane hunters are out there and they will continue to be out there for at least for the next hour or so. We'll continue, of course, to bring you that information as we get it. There is a tropical storm warning up for the coast of South Carolina. That means tropical storm conditions are expected, but tropical storm conditions are really tied to the wind. 39 mile per hour winds or higher, and this is not a wind bag. It's not a wind story. It's a rain story, and that's what you're seeing here on the radar is quite a bit of rainfall, getting a little bit of a break here in Charleston. It's been raining pretty steady there all day long, really since the noontime hours. They've had several inches of rain so far, but the wind's not terrible. I've seen wind gusts as high as 26 miles per hour down here in Hilton Head Island, but Myrtle Beach, where our own Mike Seidel has been reporting from, not too bad up there. A few of these rain showers going to be moving onshore during the overnight hours there up into the Wilmington area. But overall, we're forecasting anywhere from 3 to 5 additional inches of rain, and the rainfall threat is going to stay, we think, through the holiday weekend, really into Monday, and then maybe lingering into Tuesday, more up into the mid-Atlantic states. So let's take a look at the, this is the upper level conditions. Again, the winds fanning out at the upper part of the atmosphere is helping to enhance the rainfall and keep the showers and thunderstorms to the north of this system. And as I was saying, expect it to just sort of edge its way inland sometime tomorrow, but it's not really, it doesn't really matter where the center of this comes ashore, Nick and Mike, because obviously its impacts are far away from where the center is, already seeing those on shore.
Michael, thank you for that very much. Well, let's update you on the forecast for the rest of the country for your holiday weekend.
Yeah, we'll continue to see, of course, that wet weather across the south, some of that making its way up into the mid-Atlantic and into New England as well, and then the severe threats here in the middle of the nation.
Yeah, this area, the possibility we could have some tornadoes in their Torcon of 3 here. Phoenix, though, almost 100 degrees tomorrow. Nick, you're at the pool tomorrow in Phoenix.
Oh, I tell you what, we're going to have lots of sunshine on the West Coast as we head into Memorial Day. And look at that, Seattle, 70 degrees. Beautiful. And sunshine. They got the Northwest Folk Life Festival. All the folk musicians come out of the woodwork. It's a great weekend.
That has your name written all over it, my friend. In San Francisco down to Phoenix, look at the sunshine abundant here for your Monday. So Memorial Day looking really good West Coast.
Yeah, and then we've got parade weather here in Washington, D.C. Let's talk about it. You've got it. Rain pretty much all day long here on Memorial Day. By the time we get into 10 p.m., maybe it'll stop, but parades will be long over by then.
No joke. We've got it highlighted there, the time of the parade. That is not a fun forecast for you. Take the ponchos. Have a good time out there. Listen to the bands. Pay tribute to those that have served in our military. But it's a very soggy forecast here in D.C.
Yeah, it really is. Well, we've got a lot of soggy places, no doubt. And our coverage of this holiday weekend's severe weather threat, along with Tropical Storm Bonnie for the Southeast Coast, when we come back. And that is just 60 seconds away.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Tropical Storm Bonnie off the Carolina coast. We can expect tropical storm conditions in this area tonight and early Sunday.
And millions are flocking to the beaches for the unofficial start to summer this Memorial Day weekend. We've got live coverage of the impacts and expert analysis on where the storm is headed next. It's all ahead.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for staying with us right here for our special coverage on the Weather Channel. We're tracking Tropical Storm Bonnie. And want to also welcome in our friends watching us on Local Now. Good evening to you. I'm Mike Bettis.
And I'm Nick Walker, keeping a close eye on conditions as we continue throughout the evening and in the overnight hours where we're going to get a lot of wet weather.
It's definitely going to be a soggy one. Let's take you right to the action this evening, right to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Meteorologist Mike Seidel is there tonight.
And Mike, what are we seeing in terms of rain now? I know the wind is basically non-existent, but we still have the rain coming down?
Still got the rain coming down. You can see that on the radar. Take a look coming into the Grand Strand, but also notice north of here, you get up towards Carolina Beach and up towards Wilmington. The first rain showers of the day trying to eke their way north and inland towards the Wilmington area, Wrightsville Beach. Beautiful, beautiful beach area. I was there for Floyd back in 99. This is no Floyd. This is a far cry from anything like Floyd was in the Carolinas with the flooding. And I believe it came in as a high-end Cat 2, but remember, it came towards Florida a few days earlier as a 5 and then made that right turn, fortunately, at least for the Sunshine State. Okay, back to business today. We don't have hardly any wind. You can see the palmetto trees. The palm trees not moving. And we look down the coast. That's the beautiful Grand Strand. We're looking north, all those high-rise hotels, and you can see lights in the distance, and there's not the murky appearance. So the rainfall is not very hard. The ceiling is relatively high, and that's what we've been dealing with all day. Certainly, this is the heaviest shower we've seen. We've probably picked up about a tenth of an inch. Officially at the airport, 2/100ths of an inch of rain over the past hour. We're now up to 1/13ths of an inch at the airport in North Myrtle Beach. So this is what we're dealing with, guys, tonight and tomorrow, on and off showers. The short-term concern for the heavy rain will be in the low country between Charleston and Beaufort, Hilton Head Island, and back inland towards not only US 17 but I-95. Those areas have already had upwards locally of 3 inches of rain, and the Storm Prediction Center has put out a mezzo on concern about another additional 2 to 4 inches locally between now and say 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. So we may see some localized flash flooding kick in. We'll keep you updated with that as we roll through the evening and overnight hours. Much the same we've been talking about all day, the rip currents and the rain, the two impacts with Bonnie as we roll on through the rest of Memorial Day weekend here on the Grand Strand and eventually up the Eastern Seaboard. The rain heads towards the big cities and the beaches tonight, tomorrow, and Monday.
Yeah, a lot of tropical moisture headed northward. Thanks so much, Mike Seidel. So we've got a lot of people who may be in their vehicles over the next couple of days. Yeah. Watch the roadways for sure. Flooded roads.
And I look at Mike Seidel there. You were probably planning on board shorts and sunscreen this weekend. Seidel, it's rain gear, rain gear, rain gear. Michael, yeah. That's the story, huh?
You don't want to see Seidel in your town that needs some bad news. This is one of these sort of annoying storms that, you know, ultimately, this isn't going to be some sort of retired thing. This is not something, obviously, you need to board up or evacuate for. But it's a nice little gentle reminder that we are coming into the start, the traditional start of the Atlantic hurricane season, June the 1st. So we're going to start seeing more of these type of things pop up where we get tropical storms. We've already had two so far this calendar year, a bit unusual because we've only had 3 years going back to 1950 where we've had two tropical cyclones before June the 1st. The winds are 40 miles per hour. It's been moving nearly stationary, hasn't been moving. That's sort of the big story of the night. It's sitting over some pretty warm waters here, but notice the convection. The thunderstorms are being blown over into Charleston, and also the cloud tops are warming a little bit. In other words, you're not seeing as many of the reds and the oranges here, so it's looking a little bit less impressive, and that's obviously a good thing. But we want to see this resume its course. We're going to get an update from the Hurricane Center here next hour at the 11 o'clock hour, I should say. So stay tuned, and we'll bring you the latest once we get that. In terms of what the conditions are here at the coast, I mean, obviously, there's the rainfall that's moving in. Mike Seidel's up here in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Not as bad up there. You can see there was a little bit of a break in the rain, light showers, but it's mainly down here in Charleston, into areas to the south, Kiawah Island, Folly Beach. They really bore the brunt, at least, of the rainfall. And some of those gusty winds, the highest wind gusts I've seen are about 26 miles per hour down here on Hilton Head Island. So, again, this is not a big wind event, and it's not even a big, huge rain event. We just have to watch to make sure that those rain showers don't feed and sit over the same areas. Though this is a concern for those people that are considering getting in the water. I'll talk about that in a second. Here's the forecast from the Hurricane Center. The center of this tropical storm will be moving in sometime tomorrow, but, you know, that's kind of an academic thing because the impacts are already there, and then you can see slowly moving here and bringing some of that rainfall up through parts of North Carolina into the Mid-Atlantic and the lower Chesapeake, and then really quickly, just want to touch on the rip current risk. These are the channels of water that flow back out to sea, and if you get caught in one of these things, it's awfully hard to get out of one, and there's a high risk of rip currents really across the entire East Coast. That includes even down here into parts of North Florida. So I know you don't want to hear this, Mike, but if you're going to the beach this weekend, watch for those red flags, and please, please stay out of the water.
Absolutely. No, you have to in these kind of situations. Michael, thank you very much. The other thing we're following for you tonight, severe weather across the Midwest, back down through the southern plains. Some pretty active weather this evening and some weather you need to be aware of. So some storms have fired up here with a squall line, Milwaukee back down near St. Louis, and then storms erupting here across Texas as well with numerous severe thunderstorm warnings. This is an impressive squall line here. For some of you, you're going to be dealing with some hail. Others of you will be dealing with some pretty gusty winds. We have one severe thunderstorm warning here near Ottawa. This is LaSalle County, Oglesby, Ottawa, and South Ottawa. A heads up for some the possibility here of some strong winds and the possibility also of some bigger hail. Our warning goes until 9:15 this evening. I like this squall line, boy. That's a pretty squall line. Sheboygan, Milwaukee, back down through Waukegan. But I'm going to tilt this three-dimensionally and give you a different view of it here, because one thing I've noticed here in the last couple of frames on the radar is the heights of the storms are coming down a little bit, which means the storms could be weakening some. No severe thunderstorm warnings on any of them, and I suspect that the hail threat is going to go down pretty significantly as well. In fact, the storm's almost collapsing once they come near Milwaukee this evening. Storms are going to lose their instability. Sun goes down. Storms fade out. And most of you through the night will see your weather improve. And tomorrow morning for most of the Midwest, it's generally just going to be cloudy skies. Don't anticipate a whole lot of rain coming our way. Farther south on that line, Crawford, Franklin, Washington counties outside of St. Louis, Missouri, under a severe thunderstorm warning here. And then storms back down across Texas. Numerous warnings here. Large hail, a big risk. We're talking more about the storms and Tropical Storm Bonnie on the other side of the break.
And I turn around and there's three rattlesnakes.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Don't worry, Rob, you're covered.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
Bring on the competition. A fistful of crayons and a forecast full of yuck. Bring on soccer balls, winter blues, and barbecues. Bring it all on. You've got durable, affordable Olympic on your team. Bring on the competition.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer. Our longest lasting Energizer Max ever.
Don't miss out on big Memorial Day savings happening right now at Lowe's. Like up to $40 off all paint and primer and select stains, sealants, and resurfacers via rebate. Plus, get select perennials three for only $10. Hurry in today to make your home happy at Lowe's.
Mission allergy escape.
For those who've gone to extremes to escape their unrelenting nasal allergy symptoms.
News alert, new from the makers of Claritin, Claraspray.
Welcome back. Claraspray is a nasal allergy spray that contains the number one prescribed, clinically proven ingredient. Nothing is more effective at relieving your sneezing, runny nose, and nasal congestion. Return to the world with new Claraspray.
One of the things I will always tell everybody that was my favorite time at the Weather Channel was when there's a severe weather outbreak, working right alongside Dr. Greg Forbes.
You get why people are just in awe of him when you see him in action during tornado warning or severe weather. There is nobody who could do that kind of weather analysis.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
What makes me a weather geek? The fact that I love the weather, especially when it's hit me in the side of the face.
I'm gonna ride this one out, guys.
Be one of the thousands of weather geeks out there at weloveweather.tv.
I don't want to live with the uncertainties of Hep C.
Or wonder whether I should seek treatment. I am ready.
Because today, there's Harvoni, a revolutionary treatment for the most common type of chronic hepatitis C. Harvoni is proven to cure up to 99% of patients who've had no prior treatment. It transformed treatment as the first cure that's one pill once a day for 12 weeks. Certain patients can be cured with just 8 weeks of Harvoni. Harvoni is a simple treatment regimen that's been prescribed to more than 250,000 patients. Tell your doctor if you've had a liver transplant, other liver or kidney problems, HIV, or any other medical conditions, and about all the medicines you take, including herbal supplements. Taking amiodarone with Harvoni may cause a serious slowing of your heart rate. Common side effects of Harvoni may include tiredness, headache, and weakness.
I am ready to put Hep C behind me.
I am ready to be cured.
Are you ready? Ask your Hep C specialist if Harvoni is right for you.
All right, Memorial Day weekend, the unofficial start to summer, right? But it's also bringing some tropical weather to the southeast beaches.
Yeah, take a look at Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. We shot these pictures earlier of the flags going up and the lifeguard saying, okay, time to come in, out of the water now. Nobody's going in the water here. We've got a rip current threat that is going to continue through your Memorial Day holiday.
Let's talk a little bit more about that now with meteorologist Mike Seidel. He joins us live from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Hey guys, the rain continues. It's very light in nature, and we'll scan the palm trees here at the hotel and notice not much movement. The wind is not an issue. As Michael Lowry, I heard him say earlier, the peak wind gust he's seen all day, 26 miles an hour. That's not going to knock out any power, and we never thought it was going to be much of an issue, the wind. It's all about the surf, the rip currents, and the rainfall. The only concern in the short term with heavy rain, it could cause some problems down there in what we call the Carolina, South Carolina low country. That's Charleston area, the south part of the state, down towards the Savannah River, and already we've had local amounts of up to 3 inches. The airport in Charleston's had over an inch and a half, so if we throw more rain in there in the next 5 to 6 hours, another, say, 2 to 3 inches, we could have some localized flooding. The best bet tonight, just stay home, enjoy your Memorial Day weekend down there around Berkeley and Dorchester counties, and also over towards one of my favorite stops, Goose Creek, South Carolina. The beaches today were fairly busy until lunchtime. Then we had a few light showers while in. But even with the rain on and off, a lot of folks up and down the beach walking around, checking out the shells, and folks going in the surf. Surf temperature now 75, so it's getting up there to be more swimmable. As though we roll on through the June and July months, we'll see water temps here generally ending up about 82 to 84 degrees. So, guys, that's the status here. In fact, I can pull the hood down. The rain is just about stopped for now. We'll have more showers rolling in tonight and tomorrow, and it's all a function of where this thing meanders. I just looked at the latest RPM, Mike, and it looks like most of the rain tomorrow is going to fall inland away from the beach. So Columbia, Florence, up and down 95 could get more rainfall than we actually see here on the Grand Strand if that model is perfect. And it's, of course, not perfect, Nick.
But then again, what is? All right. Thanks so much, Mike Sandel. Appreciate it. Let's talk about Charleston a little bit, because we have had a bit more rainfall there than we've had at Myrtle Beach. We're looking at 1 to 2 inches that has already fallen here from Tropical Storm Bonnie, and getting more even as we speak here around the Charleston area. A lot of areas in Charleston tend to flood down there near the market area, so be careful as you're out and about. There may be some water over the roadways here through your Memorial Day holiday. Let's talk about Charleston. Tomorrow, thunderstorms, some wind, maybe gusts up to 35, 40 miles per hour. Sunday night, we'll continue to see those rainy and windy conditions. And then on Monday, a stormy Memorial Day in store for us. So here's the forecast tomorrow. We'll continue to see that onshore wind that's going to keep the rip current threat alive. We'll find that on into Sunday night as well. The rain continuing here around South Carolina, and some of this moving pretty far inland, all the way to Columbia. We'll see rain from Wilmington all the way into Raleigh, up the coast, up into Norfolk, Virginia, and it looks like even more so as we head on into your Monday up into the Northeast. So rain is probably going to be anywhere from, say, 3 to 5 inches here in the southern portions of South Carolina, maybe 2 to 3 inches from, say, Charleston northward. And we're talking areas here up into North Carolina and Virginia that might see that much as well. Lesser amounts the farther inland you move. Charleston, look for periods of rain, thunder, lightning, gusty winds as we head through tonight and Monday. High surf and rip currents, that's going to be a big story. And even if the clouds part a little bit, the rain stops, the rip current threat is still going to be very much intact, so you don't want to go into the water. Minor flooding is possible, as we've mentioned. We could see some of that even overnight tonight. Mike?
Nick, thank you very much. Hey, coming up here in our coverage, tracking the threat of severe weather right now as well. Where's the risk the greatest? We're going to take you into the Midwest and the Deep South when we come back here on the Weather Channel.
And I just wanted to say, GEICO is proud to have served the military for over 75 years.
Roger that. Cap is waiting to give you a tour of the Wisconsin now.
Could have parked a little bit closer. It's going to be dark by the time I get there.
GEICO, proudly serving the military for over 75 years.
Ace is a place with the helpful hardware, folks.
I gave Bob some tips on painting with a roller.
Ace is a place where better coverage starts with overlapping W's on your wobble walls.
Don't miss the Ace Memorial Day paint sale. Buy 2 gallons of Clark and Kensington and get one free.
Fall in love with a new daily fiber. New Mirafiber from the makers of Miralax. It's the only fiber that supports regularity with daily comfort fiber. So unlike others, Mirafiber is less likely to cause unwanted gas. Love your fiber. New Mirafiber.
The Summer Prep Package is here at Pep Boys. You get new installed wipers, tire rotation, fuel system service, alignment and pressure check, brake system, battery, coolant, and an AC check, all just $14.99 for rewards members. Pep Boys, trust the boys to get you there.
Working on my feet all day gave me pain here.
In my knees.
But now, I step on this machine and get my number, which matches my Dr. Scholl's custom fit orthotic inserts. Now I get immediate relief from my foot pain.
My knee pain.
Find a machine at drscholls.com.
Climate, environment, science, weather, technology, they're the topics of our lives right now. So let's talk about them.
Every day you get to accept things as they are or take responsibility for changing them.
The people of Flint, Michigan, it's like we don't matter.
It's such a real issue that's right in front of us. We get to change the course of history.
Let's have a conversation. And together, we can solve these things.
23.5 degrees, Tuesday nights at 11 on the Weather Channel.
The Spring Collection event is going on now at Alpacker Lincoln. Enjoy exceptional savings on our most popular Lincoln models. Like a 2016 Lincoln MKX, just $339 a month. Or a new 2016 Lincoln Navigator, just $599 a month. Plus, bottom line windshield pricing on over 200 new Lincolns. Only at Alpacker Lincoln on Military Trail. And remember,
before you buy, price Packer.
On the train test range, you learn what makes our heating and cooling systems so reliable. If there's a breaking point, we'll find it. It's hard to stop a train. Really hard.
How fast are Allegra gel caps?
They're rise and shine fast.
Buddy's ready to go fast. For allergy symptoms, Allegra is the fastest non-drowsy relief you can buy.
Their fun shouldn't wait fast.
Allegra Gel Caps. Not just fast, Allegra Fast. Guaranteed or your money back.
Stay tuned for your local in the 8, brought to you by AARP. Real possibilities.
Connecting with my friends, love it. Connecting with some sketchy guy from a block number who just called saying he's with a tech company that needs remote access to my computer to block a virus he detected. Really?
Hey, we hear you. That's why AARP created the Fraud Watch Network, to help you protect your family with information on the latest scams so you can spot fraud from a mile away.
If you don't think this is right for me when you think AARP, then you don't know ARP. Get to know us at aarp.org/possibilities.
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible, high 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies, low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Channel. Following severe storms for you this evening, Chicago, you could be a target. Storms aren't that far away. That's a look at Michigan Avenue, and everything's dry for now. Storms are just to your west, okay? And so heads up late tonight. You're going out late this evening, or, you know, maybe you're planning on a special evening with some friends out, or maybe a little date night with a spouse? Heads up on the conditions as they come in. All right, let's update you what's happening here in the Midwest. Chicago, you're not alone. We've had some storms around St. Louis, especially south of St. Louis. Then up around, say, Waukegan, Milwaukee, and Sheboygan this evening. Pretty impressive little squall line here, and they're the storms that are lining up for us now. Still about two counties away for you in Chicago, and they may weaken some before they actually get there. But this storm line here coming through Milwaukee has weakened a little bit. We don't have any severe thunderstorm warnings on this right now, but still heavy rain. You're going to get some lightning with that as well. The good news is storms through the night, now the sun's setting, will lose some instability, now tend to bring the storm's intensity down some. And so tomorrow when you head out, mainly just cloudy skies for some of you. I don't think we'll be dealing with a lot of rain. If we have any showers, they'll be scattered in nature through, say, the UP of Michigan, the Arrowhead of Minnesota, and then central Wisconsin. Take you farther south on that line, including south of St. Louis, Franklin, Jefferson, and Washington counties are all under severe thunderstorm warnings right now. Now there's storms riding now just to the east of I-44. Back down through Texas, a lot of storms here. Several of them have severe thunderstorm warnings on them. I'll watch for some flooding that could occur with these storms as well, with some of those storms relatively stationary. Abilene, we had a severe thunderstorm warning earlier, but notice how that storm has now shifted off to your east and weakened just a little bit. Here's the future radar for us across Texas. Notice how our dry line retreating back into New Mexico. A few storms still around San Angelo this evening, right around the Red River Valley. A few showers for you around San Antonio. Again, I think flooding may be one of the bigger issues as we go through the night for a place like Dallas. I think we'll hold off on the storms for tonight. Here's a look at our forecast for tomorrow, lighting it up once again through the Texas Panhandle and all the way up through, say, Dodge City, Kansas, up around Lamar as well. Our Torcon is a 3 Southern Texas Panhandle, so a place like Lubbock, just heads up, about a 30% chance that tornadoes could become calling for you. Lansing, Detroit, Cleveland, Columbus, Fort Wayne, all in the crosshairs tomorrow for high winds and the possibility of some hail. And then on Memorial Day itself, scattered storms across a good chunk of the country, but the severe weather is right through Tornado Alley from Bismarck to Sioux Falls, back down through Amarillo and Midland. All these locations could be looking for the possibility of high winds, hail, and an isolated tornado. Nick?
Hey, we had some thunderstorms very close to New York City earlier today. They popped up in that warm, humid air mass, and it's still warm out there right now. 81 degrees after a high temperature today, just 2 degrees shy of the record. 92 is where you got to at Central Park today. You got more rain on the way. It looks like it's coming in tomorrow night, and you'll have a Monday that is going to be rainy off and on pretty much throughout your Memorial Day. Monday night will begin to taper it off just a bit. But a lot of the Northeast is going to be the recipients of some of that tropical moisture that's moving in with Tropical Storm Bonnie. That is going to be making its way northward up through the Mid-Atlantic, eventually into the Northeast, due to the fact that we've got this jet stream that is making its way eastward, and a cold front at the surface, this weak cold front, is moving eastward. And so this moisture is going to be kind of squeezed up in between the coast and the cold front there. And so that means a lot of us are going to experience a pretty wet Memorial Day holiday, and some of us even before that. Sunday, it looks wet here around, say, Washington, D.C., much of Virginia. Sunday night, it all moves northward. So by Sunday night, New York City and Boston are going to get some of that wet weather, moving up into northern New England as we head through Monday. So more up and down the coast here. Still some warm weather, that tropical moisture, and maybe even a thunderstorm or two as well. The total rain forecast isn't going to be, you know, over the top, 1 to 2 inches here, say, from New York City southward to Philadelphia and down toward Washington, D.C. Well, coming up more in our top story, that's Tropical Storm Bonnie, the latest timing and the impacts, and wind conditions along the southeast coast will deteriorate.
When looking for a van to take your business to the next level, look for more. With the Ram ProMaster and ProMaster City, you can do more. Handle more, organize more, and get more out of every drop, all for less. Now, current competitive commercial owners or lessees are eligible for these cash allowances on the 2016 Ram ProMaster City.
More people are driving Ram trucks than ever before. Guts, glory, Ram.
As you'll see, when shoppers add an item to their jet carts, they automatically shrink the prices of millions of other products.
Very impressive.
It's got a little kick to it.
Sir, I can't hear you.
Nice shirt, Craig.
At Jet.com, we always find innovative ways to save. Get 15% off your first order.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer. Our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
Save at the Men's Warehouse Memorial Day Sale. Buy one, get one free on most sport coats, dress slacks, dress shirts, and sportswear. Plus, all designer jeans are two for $100. And select designer suits are $249.99. Men's Warehouse. Rise to the occasion.
At Bridgestone, our engineers want to help make sure you're not stuck on the side of the road. Our revolutionary drive guard tires are engineered to take a puncture and drive up to 50 miles.
Ready to go.
Watch our latest Archer demo at BridgestoneTire.com.
I recommend Nature Made Vitamins because I trust their quality. They were the first to have a vitamin verified by USP, an independent organization that sets strict quality and purity standards.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended vitamin and supplement brand.
These outdoor furnishings from Lowe's are so stylish, it almost feels like we're inside the house. Not that I've been in there. Or have I?
Now get Garden Treasures Cascade Creek Patio Dining Sets for only $3.48 at Lowe's.
And I turn around and there's 3 rattlesnakes.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Don't worry, Rob, you're covered.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
Seresto makes it easy to help protect your dog or cat from fleas and ticks. With the performance you expect from a monthly topical in a non-greasy collar, Seresto kills and repels fleas and ticks for 8 continuous months. Seresto from Bayer.
Poor mouth breather. Allergies, stuffy nose, can't sleep. Take that. A Breathe Right nasal strip instantly opens your nose, up to 38% more than allergy medicine alone. Shut your mouth and say goodnight, mouth breathers. Breathe Right.
One of the things I will always tell everybody that was my favorite time at the Weather Channel is when there's a severe weather outbreak, working right alongside Dr. Greg Forbes.
You get why people are just in awe of him when you see him in action during tornado warning or severe weather. There is nobody who could do that kind of weather analysis.
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. tonight. Cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing. Low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back into the Weather Channel. Our special coverage this evening, Tropical Storm Bonnie along the southeast coast.
And we are watching the rain continue to come in. We want to welcome our friends, too, watching us live on Local Now as we continue to see the rain. Not a lot of wind, but rain picking up in some places.
Yeah, indeed. There's the view for you this evening. Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Temperatures are in the 70s right now. And I think this is really the thing. Mm-hmm. People don't want rain on their holiday weekend, especially going down to the beach. You're thinking, I'm going to get on the boogie board. I'm going to get out there. I'm going to have a good time. Not so much with this in your forecast.
You get this picture in your mind of the way it's going to be, and you got to just somehow change
Mother
that picture.
Nature just throws that curveball, doesn't she?
Well, Mike Seidel is in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, watching this curveball. And so let's get an update from him right now. And if you've been able to talk to some of the folks, Mike, are they beginning to get a little bit of a different mindset of change of plans?
No, they're here for the long haul, either today, coming in yesterday and today, or staying until tomorrow, Monday. Holiday weekend, you book your hotel in advance, you hope for the best, and you really can't cancel these days. Hotels have these cancellation policies that start 48 hours out. In fact, where we're staying, I think the cancellation policy is about 5 days out. So you got to come down and make the best of it. We've got a little wind right now. The palmetto trees buffeting. These winds running at about 15 miles an hour. The peak gusts I've seen, I just checked the latest observation, way down to our south, Hilton Head, South Carolina. Hilton Head Island, beautiful place. They've gusted the past hour to 31 miles an hour. That is not going to cause any problems with power or blowing much of anything around. In fact, I showed you earlier the trash cans here at Myrtle Beach are on the beach. Good sign that they're not concerned. The city is not concerned about anything being blown down the beach. So we get a break in the rain right now, but you can see on the radar there's still rain up the coast towards Carolina Beach. In fact, we've got a report of a missing swimmer. Our news desk is checking that out to confirm that. Not confirm, but just to give you a heads up, we also heard earlier that there were plenty of rescues out of the surf up in North Carolina. That's because of these rip currents. Down here, we didn't have any rescues at Myrtle Beach. Talked to the beach patrol because they limited activities to about knee deep, and then later in the day, they said just ankle deep. They said, we're not going to take the chances because when you have situations like this, it's too risky and they end up blowing their whistles. And rip currents are pretty dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. So we're going to deal with this kind of pattern next couple days, the rip currents, the rainfall, and we'll see how things shake out tomorrow once the center gets on shore and how fast or how slowly it festers and meanders up through the eastern Carolinas. That has a big impact on the forecast. Right now, Mike, we've got an 80% chance of rain in Myrtle Beach Sunday and Monday. Then the chance of rain will start to diminish by Tuesday. Mike Bettis, back to you.
Mike Seidel, thank you for that report very, very much. All right, Michael Lowry joining us now with a look at the tropics. It's not a good forecast. It's not fun by any means.
Not at all.
No, not at all. You know, and we've been really talking about the rip current risk, the ocean conditions, extremely dangerous, guys. I mean, this is going to continue into tomorrow and even into Monday. This is not something that as this comes ashore that the rip current problem just goes away. In fact, in often cases, the rip currents are worse after the passage of a storm because the waves break. They create that channel in the sandbar, and the channel is what creates the rip currents, and then the storm leaves, but the channel's still there behind. So if you're at the beach, you're going to want to avoid getting in the water really through the weekend. We just got the latest information in from the National Hurricane Center, so I want to go ahead and bring that to you. This is literally just in, fresh off the press. 45 mile per hour wind, so they have upped the winds just a tad from 40 miles per hour on Tropical Storm Bonnie, and it is still stationary, so that's not something that we want to see. We want to see movement to this storm. The longer it sits there, the greater the chance it has to produce more rainfall and also sort of a small window for it to maybe get a little bit stronger, but I don't expect it to get much stronger than it is now because the wind shear, the strong winds at the upper part of the atmosphere are there in place. And also look at the cloud shield here. The warm cloud tops, or sorry, the cold cloud tops are warming right now. And so we'll hope that trend continues. The convection, the thunderstorms really north of where the center is. So the weather is already onshore. It doesn't matter if the center is offshore. There are tropical storm warnings up for the coast of South Carolina only. That means tropical storm conditions, winds of 39 miles per hour or higher, obviously expected here. But really, overall, the winds have been less than tropical storm strength so far. Yeah, we have seen gusts up to near 30 miles per hour down here, especially in Hilton Head. You can see that they're seeing some of the heavier rain showers here. The center of Tropical Storm Bonnie is right here. So it's not all that far from the shore, but we need to get it moving a little bit because once it moves inland, then the low pressure system can weaken a little bit and, things will start to get a little bit better. Up here in Myrtle Beach, where Mike Seidel is, they've sort of been in and out of the rain showers this afternoon, and even Charleston getting a little bit of a break here. So it's better news, I think, even though this is coming on shore, just because we've had so much of that rain in advance of the storm. But still, there is still a few strong, especially in this band right here. We want to watch this, and if this starts to train over, especially Hilton Head, they could see some problems in here. So south of Charleston, we'll want to watch closely during the overnight hours as this edges closer to the coastline. Here is the forecast from the Hurricane Center as of 11 o'clock. I think this is the update from the Hurricane Center. We're thinking sometime tomorrow, maybe during late morning to early afternoon hours, that the system bodily will come ashore and then just sort of meander through the early week. So a lot of this rainfall is going to combine with a frontal system that's coming from the west, and that's going to create some rainfall or bring some rainfall, I should say, to parts of the mid-Atlantic up through the lower Chesapeake into the early week, the early Memorial Day week. Mike, back over to you.
Mike, thank you very much. Let's take you into St. Louis this evening and show you what's going on. It's 83 degrees right now. I've had some stormy weather, especially down to our south. We've had a squall line that's extended from Wisconsin back down through Missouri, but around St. Louis, we've been spared for the most part, but it's been a very warm day for you today, a little mugginess to the air this evening. On the radar, what you'll end up seeing is a pretty decent line that's held together here for the last couple of hours, and for many of you, it's meant some lightning, it's meant some hail, it's meant some wind in Milwaukee. I think you got spared here. Although the storm came right over top of you, it really was like a force field, if we will, over Milwaukee. There's a look at all the hail and high wind reports we've had, really clustered, by the way, up here through Wisconsin and then northern Illinois. But again, as they were just coming into Sheboygan and Milwaukee and Waukegan, they died down quite a bit. And the storms that were severe warned near Chicago, all those warnings have expired in Chicago, maybe a couple more hours before it comes your way. But notice how that thing has really started to fall apart now. It doesn't mean that you're not getting some heavy rain and maybe some rumbles of thunder still out there, but not nearly as potent as it once was. And you do not want to be on the boat tonight. You got to keep that in dock this evening. Here's a look at our future radar. The storm's diminishing through the night. That squall line pushing east and basically losing its oomph. So I don't think you're any worse for wear in Chicago overnight tonight. In St. Louis, I think you'll be in pretty decent shape as well. Let's head farther south now. A few storms around Texas this evening, mostly over rural areas. Abilene, we had one good storm that came right over town with some hail that's now rolling along I-20, and it is falling apart here. So I think your travels on I-20 will be in a much better shape. Here's a look at the forecast for tomorrow. It does include the Texas Panhandle, San Angelo, Lubbock, Amarillo, Dodge City. These are all places that could be hit by storms. And a tornado risk that is there, a 3 out of 10 on the torque on the southern Texas Panhandle, or a 30% chance of tornadoes. Nick?
And Mike, we actually had a thunderstorm pop up around central portions of Massachusetts in that warm, muggy air today. It was warm in Boston, wasn't it? 92 degrees. That tied the record from 1931. And look at this. In Albany, New York, we beat the record that's over 100 years old there. Concord, New Hampshire tied the record from 1978. Newark, New Jersey beat the 1959 record of 92 by 4 degrees with a 96 degree high. A lot of warmth continuing into tomorrow. We've got this upper level ridge in place. We've got this area of high pressure out over the Atlantic that's helping to steer Bonnie into the Carolinas, but also steering some southerly winds, that warm air, up into the Northeast. And so look at the temperatures. We're going to see those 10 to 20 degrees above average. Maybe not widespread 90s, but in some cases, near record high temperatures. Look at Buffalo, 87 degrees tomorrow. Burlington, 87. That's 15 degrees above your average. And New York City, Boston, Philadelphia, yeah, you're going to find those temperatures once again up into the 80s. Well, Boston's going to be considerably cooler. All right, we'll talk more about what's to come into the rest of your Memorial Day weekend.
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
We've got that thing. You know, diarrhea, abdominal pain.
But we said we'd be there.
Who makes the decisions around here? It's me. Don't think I'll make it. Stomach again. Send.
If you're living with frequent, unpredictable diarrhea and abdominal pain, you may have irritable bowel syndrome with diarrhea or IBS-D, a condition that can be really frustrating. Talk to your doctor about Viberzi, a different way to treat IBS-D. Viberzi is a prescription medication you take every day that helps proactively manage both diarrhea and abdominal pain at the same time, so you stay ahead of your symptoms. Viberzi can cause new or worsening abdominal pain. Do not take Viberzi if you have or may have had pancreas or severe liver problems, problems with alcohol abuse, long-lasting or severe constipation, or a blockage of your bowel or gallbladder. If you're taking Viberzi, you should not take medicines that cause constipation. The most common side effects of Viberzi include constipation, nausea, and abdominal pain. Stay ahead of IBS-D with Viberzi.
You found the love of your dreams, and together, you had the kid of your dreams. Now you can put them in the car of your dreams for a lot less than you might think. With a certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz, you can enjoy legendary safety, innovation, and performance at a price you can afford. And that's a pretty sweet dream. Visit the certified pre-owned sales event now through May 31st. Only at your authorized dealer. Mercedes-Benz. The best or nothing.
Bring on the competition. A fistful of crayons. Then a forecast full of yuck. Bring on soccer balls and laundry baskets. Winter blues and barbecues. Bring it all on. You've got Olympic on your team. With affordable paints that withstand up to 1,500 scrubs. And stains that stay beautiful. Tough, durable, guaranteed. Olympic. Bring on the competition.
This Memorial Day, save $10 via rebate on Olympic paints and stains. Available at Lowe's.
What's it like to be in good hands? Man, it's like pure power at your fingertips. Like the power to earn Allstate reward points every time I drive.
Want my number?
And cash back for driving safe. And the power to automatically find your car. I see you, car. And I got the power to know who's coming and when if I break down.
You must be Jerry.
Hey. N means getting more from your car insurance with the all-powerful DriveWise app.
It's good to be in good hands.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer. Our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
You travel easier knowing that a perfect stay awaits at Country Inns and Suites. Book now at countryinns.com. Relax, the rest comes easy.
Don't miss out on big Memorial Day savings now at Lowe's. Like up to 30% off select major appliances $396 or more. Plus, get up to 24-month special financing on qualifying purchases with your Lowe's consumer credit card. Hurry in today to make your home happy at Lowe's.
Seems we've hit a roadblock.
That reminds me. Anyone have occasional constipation, diarrhea, gas, bloating?
Yes.
One Philips Colon Health probiotic cap each day helps defend against occasional digestive issues with three types of good bacteria. Live the regular life. Philips.
singing. Come on, get happy.
New Aquafina Sparkling. Lightness and refreshment in perfect sync. Aquafina Sparkling. For happy bodies.
New information to pass along to you this evening. A missing swimmer at Carolina Beach in North Carolina. The police department there in the Carolina Beach and Fire Department responding to reference to a call for a swimmer in distress. County fire crews and U.S. Coast Guard responding to aid in that search. Emergency personnel will continue to search for the swimmer throughout the evening. We're hearing the Coast Guard has a helicopter, a C-130, and a boat in the water right now searching for that missing person. One thing that certainly could be a risk is rip currents, all courtesy of Tropical Storm Bonnie. So we're here in the lab with our storm specialist, Michael Lowry, to give you an update on what a rip current is, how to spot it, what the danger is, how to protect yourself, because you can, as the National Weather Service says, break the grip of the rip.
Yeah.
If you're caught in one, it's okay. You just have to know what to do.
Yeah, and your best bet is, in this case especially, is to not venture into the water. The best way I can describe it is if you're crossing a busy street, you're not going to cross the interstate, right? I mean, at rush hour, and that's what we have right now in the oceans. The interstate at rush hour, and there are just rip currents everywhere.
A rip current form?
Well, a rip current forms from waves. You have to have waves, but you don't need big waves, Mike. You can have 2 or 3 feet waves, and right in the middle here, as you get closer to the shoreline, you have a sandbar, and those waves will carve out a channel within the sandbar. And so on either side of that channel, you get higher water levels and you have lower water levels in the middle. And so kind of like in the atmosphere, the water goes from high to low pressure. And this return flow that goes back out to sea through that channel, it's like a river. I mean, it travels awfully fast and it can take you out to sea. That itself, that is the rip current. It has nothing to do with the tide. It's not going to pull you under, but it will pull you out very quickly. I mean, as fast as an Olympic swimmer can swim. So it's hard sometimes to break the grip of the rip, but you can, as you were saying, if you know what to do.
All right, so the water is going to channel out and take you out. And the thing about it is, let it do that. Just stay up above the water. Keep your head above the water. Let it take you. Just relax. Float, in essence.
The best thing you can do is just kind of ride it out. The rip current, if you're trying to find one from a dune, you can find it because you'll generally have waves right here. And snuggled right in the middle of the waves, you'll see a rip current. So swim toward the white water. Swim toward the waves because the waves will push you back to shore if you're caught in a rip current. And that usually is parallel to shore.
We have this really cool thing that was done where dye was placed in the water to show you exactly where that rip is, and you can see there are no waves right in that little narrow channel there.
That's right. And then to follow the dye sort of curving back toward the shore, oftentimes these rip currents, if you give it enough time, will take you back to the shore. So to Mike's point, I mean, you just want to sort of ride it out and swim toward the waves, because the waves are going to bring you back to shore. And Mike, also something good to know is rip currents are generally the worst at low tide. So if you look at the tide cycle, low tide is the time that you want to avoid getting in the water.
To guarantee yourself no issues, stay out of the water.
Just stay out of the water.
All right,
yeah.
Michael, thank you. Nick?
All right, let's take you back to Mike Seidel. He's in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. And Mike, let's hope that we don't have any kind of, reports of people trapped in rip currents tomorrow. Let's hope they stay off the beaches. We know the flags are up there on the beach.
Yes, and as I told you through the evening, here they didn't let the swimmers venture out too far. Early in the day, it was knee-high, and then it was ankle-high. Rainfall coming down again, another shower rotating in, the wind blowing the palm trees around a little bit, gusting about 15 miles an hour or so. The heaviest rain has been down in the low country. Charleston just checked the airport. They've had 2.11 inches of rain so far. That's a daily record, smashing the previous May 28th record by right now at about 3/4 of an inch above that 1 1/3 was the previous record. So that's where all the heavy rain has been. They're getting a nice break now, though, in the Charleston area. Nick?
All right, thanks so much, Mike Seidel. We'll check back with you. And in the meantime, our coverage of Tropical Storm Bonnie continues when we come back. A look at the impacts for the Carolina coast over this holiday weekend and how long we'll have to stay inside.
Someone you know is carrying all natural 100% ground beef. Yeah, that's right. There's only one way to know how good it tastes. Try it at Walmart's low prices.
In a good, clean salad, every ingredient is the main ingredient. The strawberry poppy seed, romaine, mandarin, pineapple, blueberry, strawberry, 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 salad with chicken. At Panera, food as it should be.
You totaled your brand new car. Nobody's hurt, but there will still be pain. It comes when your insurance company says they'll only pay 3/4 of what it takes to replace it. What are you supposed to do, drive 3/4 of a car? Now, if you had Liberty Mutual new car replacement, you'd get your whole car back. I guess they don't want you driving around on 3 wheels. Smart.
With Liberty Mutual new car replacement, we'll replace the full value of your car. See car insurance in a whole new light. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
A generation has grown up trusting the Weather Channel. Coming to us for the most accurate forecast.
This is all heading into your area right now.
Relying on us for the most trusted storm coverage.
We are in the height of the storm.
There is still a lot of flooding.
There's a tornado.
Whoa!
And now, choosing us as the highest ranked TV news brand for 6 years in a row. Where you get your weather matters. So thank you for trusting the leading experts in weather.
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Partly cloudy skies. Low 73. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Do everything well?
This clean was like pow.
It felt like I had just gone to the dentist.
My teeth are glowing.
They look great.
They are so white.
6 times cleaning, 6 times whitening.
In the certain spots that I get very sensitive, I really notice a difference.
And at 2 weeks, superior sensitivity relief to Sensodyne.
I actually really like the 2 steps.
Step 1 cleans and relieves sensitivity. Step 2 whitens.
It's the whole package. No one's done this.
Crest, healthy, beautiful smiles for life.
Hey, it's me. Did you know Dell.com price matches microphones?
Yeah!
Portable speakers.
Yeah, yeah!
The XPS 13 with 6th-gen Intel Core processors.
Yeah!
Even fitness watches.
Yeah!
Oh! You okay? You want me to call a doctor?
Yeah, please.
All right. Price match guarantee at Dell.com for you glam rockers. We love your work.
Show me movies with explosions. Show me more like this. Show me previously watched. What's recommended for me?
X1 makes it easy to find what blows you away. Call or go online and switch to X1. Only with Xfinity.
Not cleaning between your teeth can cause anything as minor as bad breath to as major as gum disease. I don't think bad breath is very minor, though.
Use Gum Brand for healthy gums, soft picks, Proxibrush cleaners, flossers, and dental floss.
Your gums matter.
If you can't seem to shut down at bedtime, you're not alone. Millions of people reach for Unisom sleep gels or smaller sleep minis to fall asleep fast and wake recharged. Unisom, a stressful day deserves a restful night.
Now, what makes me a weather geek? The fact that I love the weather, especially when it's hit me in the side of the face.
I'm gonna ride this one out, guys.
Be one of the thousands of weather geeks out there at weloveweather.tv.
It's right now 53 past the hour. Welcome back to our coverage of Tropical Storm Bonnie.
And it's time now for our tropical update. So let's turn to hurricane specialist Michael Lowry. And Michael, we've got a low-grade tropical storm out there. We don't want to let our guard down, but we don't want to, you know, overplay this as well.
No, we don't. We have a long season ahead. And the last thing we want to do is, you know, to sort of hype something that doesn't need to be hyped. But then again, Nick, I mean, it is a tropical storm. It is sitting over warm waters. It's not over land yet. And so we do have to be vigilant in terms of watching this move inland. It's moving awfully slowly. In fact, it's stationary. Here is the latest information from the National Hurricane Center. And just a few hours ago, if you were with us, you noticed the location was 130 miles southeast of Beaufort, South Carolina, I should say, and now 120 miles southeast of Beaufort, South Carolina. So it hasn't really moved. The winds, though, have come up a little bit, 45 mile per hour winds. But again, this is really just sort of an academic thing. The weather with this system, you can see it's ahead of it, well ahead of it, and it's been raining cats and dogs, really, especially the southern part of South Carolina, since about the noontime hours, moderate to heavy rainfall. The pressure hasn't really changed that much, 1,008 millibars. Hurricane Hunter airplanes were in there, so these are direct measurements from our Hurricane Hunters, our Air Force planes that were out there this evening. There is a tropical storm warning up for the coast of South Carolina, means those winds of 39 miles per hour are expected here over the next 24 hours. But really, guys, this is not a windbag. This is not a wind event. It's a rain event. And when you look at the reports here along the coast, I mean, Hilton Head has gusted or is gusting to 30 miles per hour, but we haven't seen sustained winds of tropical storm strength. You know, we probably won't see widespread tropical storm strength winds. We're probably going to see those 20 to 30 mile per hour wind gusts. But what I'm watching for is you can see this really heavy rain band now that's pushing into Hilton Head and extends offshore. And, you know, these showers in tropical cyclones can set up like boxcars on a locomotive. We call it training because they move over the same area. So we'll want to watch the Hilton Head area over the next few hours into the early morning hours to make sure that we don't have any localized flooding there. Charleston, you're getting a brief reprieve here. It's good because, my goodness, it's just been raining all day long with that shield of showers now pushing into inland parts of South Carolina into Columbia and Myrtle Beach, where Mike Seidel is, getting a little bit of a break here for them up there. But again, we'll want to pay attention to hear what's happening in Hilton Head and this area south toward the South Carolina-Georgia border. Here's the water vapor picture. This is the water content and the wind flow at the middle to upper part of the atmosphere. And what I want to point out here is we have this big old dip in the jet stream. Those jet stream winds have been parked right over Tropical Storm Bonnie. I tell you what, though, if that jet stream were just a little bit to the west, it would be in a much more favorable environment. The winds wouldn't be nearly as strong. And having sat over these warm waters, you can see it's over the warmest waters in the western Atlantic Ocean. Mid 80 degree water temperatures here along the Gulf Stream water is only about 50 to 100 miles offshore. And it's really the ocean that fuels these tropical systems. But again, strong winds right here. It's on the edge of those strong winds, keeping this one in check. And that's pretty much what the forecast is, for this to stay in check as a tropical storm, a low-grade tropical storm. And then sometime tomorrow, it'll resume its course back to the coast tonight. And sometime tomorrow, the system moving bodily inland, but it doesn't really matter again because this is not a single point. This is a comma-shaped weather feature with its impacts, you know, not just right around where its center is, and also kind of raining out over parts of North Carolina into parts of Southern Virginia and the Chesapeake Bay. Overall, though, again, we're going to want to watch Hilton Head area and just south of Charleston, Mike and Nick. But overall, you know, if it's 3 to 5 inches comes over a period of a day or more, generally the soils can handle it. Back to you.
Michael, thank you very much. I can't imagine how many people planned on doing a little of this in Hilton Head.
Oh, yeah.
And they're just stuck inside this weekend.
You know, a lot of people are going to be stuck inside throughout the nation. A lot of wet spots here this weekend. And among those will be the Northeast. We're going to get another round of rain as we head into tomorrow up from the Mid-Atlantic and portions of New England. And the severe weather threat, too, in the center of the nation.
That's right. And since you're watching for tornadoes, even Torr Count of 3 here across the panhandle of Texas, 11. Mm-hmm. Boy, Denver's forecast is 75 with sunshine. San Francisco, not a cloud in the sky, upper 60s tomorrow.
We'll see even fewer clouds, I think, by the time we get into Memorial Day around the Seattle area. 70 degrees looks great there. San Francisco and Phoenix, likewise. Thunderstorms could plague you around Chicago, but again, severe weather threats through the center of the nation, all the way from the, well, the Mexican border northward.
It's pretty amazing how much that expands on Monday. So heads up here in the typical areas where the dry line is especially going to fire here down through Texas, but Brownsville will top out at 90 degrees.
Watch some of that tropical moisture moving up into the northeast as well.
All right, a lot more to come here this morning. Our coverage of this holiday weekend severe weather threat along with Tropical Storm Bonnie is still to come this evening. When we come back, we'll be checking with meteorologist Mike Seidel reporting from the beaches in Myrtle Beach.
Currently in our area, 80 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Tonight, cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing, low 73. Sunday, partly to mostly cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 87. Sunday night, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early.